Hello everyone, Wonderbro here, and today I want to talk about showing your brain the truth. And what I mean by that is, okay, that's my little catchphrase, what I mean by that is showing your brain the truth. Now, when you have worries, especially if you are sensitized, these worries and these negative thoughts are going to be amplified, okay? You're going to feel it more in your body when you are sensitized. Now, the real rational you, the you that you were before you became sensitized, before this happened to you, knows better, knows the truth. So, for example, if I have the negative fear or worry that I might go crazy, and you can apply this to any of your, worries or fears, but if I have that worry I might go crazy, if I'm sensitized, I'm really going to feel it. Because the nerves are so tired and fragile, they're willing to pop off even more now. But the real me, the person I was before sensitization, knows that I'm not going to go crazy. Okay, and that's just an example. Another one real quick, right off the top of my head. The real me knows that there's no danger in, let's just say, going to the gym or going into the grocery store. The real me knows these things. But my sensitized body is simply taking all of my negative worries as real dangers and real threats, and then I'm getting an amplified reaction in the body because I am sensitized, because my nerves are tired and fragile. But the fact remains that the real me, deep down, the rational me, knows better than all of this, knows better than to think that there's some sort of danger in the grocery store, knows better than to think that I might go crazy. The real me knows better than to think all of these irrational things. So, we have to show the brain now the truth with our behaviors, because even though we know deep down, okay, that the real me knows better, the rational me knows better, even though we know that deep down inside of us, the brain doesn't care about that. What the brain cares about is your behaviors. What the brain cares about is what you're telling it with your behaviors, whether you're using acceptance or not. That's all the brain cares about. So we can know that rationally we are being irrational. We can know that rationally we are just sensitized. But even though we do know that, the brain could care less. The brain has to be shown with your behaviors now that there is no tiger in the room, that there is no dragon, that there is no danger. So we can go to the grocery store and be walking around and feel extremely anxious because we're sensitized, and we can know deep down that there's no danger in the grocery store, but we are behaving fearfully because we don't like the anxiety and we're afraid of it. The brain doesn't know that. The brain is just going to assume that there is a tiger in the grocery store with you. Okay, so even though we know these things deep down, we have to show the brain that. And that's a good way to look at it, because if you get so lost in this thing that you're just thinking to yourself, oh, you know, this is who I've become, you know, apparently I'm just so irrational these days. No, you're not. It's not that you're irrational. It's that you're sensitized and your nerves can't regulate properly. So you're reacting. You're having strong reactions in the body due to your negative thoughts and worries because you are sensitized. That's what it comes down to at the end of the day. It's because you are sensitized, nothing more, nothing less. So remind yourself of that. You're not some irrational person. You haven't changed. You're still that rational person. You know these things deep down. Like I said, you know there's no danger in the grocery store. You know you're not going to go crazy. You know that you're being triggered because you are sensitized. So you haven't changed. Remind yourself of that and simply say to yourself, I know there's no real danger here. I know that. I do, but now I have to show my brain that with my behaviors, because that's what my brain has to go on, is how I'm behaving when anxiety is turned on. Is this person behaving in a fearful, unaccepting manner? Because if they are, there must be a real danger, and I need to continue protecting them with anxiety. So the brain's just doing what we're telling it to do with our behaviors. So remind yourself, you know, I haven't changed. I'm still rational. I know better than all of this. I know better. This isn't the real me. But now I have to show my brain. So, you know, with my behaviors, I know better. but now I have to show my brain with my behaviors, because that's all it has to go off of. It can't read your mind and see you up there going, okay, you know, I know this isn't true, I'm rational, and but yet you're still acting fearful on the outside. It needs to see you behave in an accepting manner to come to the conclusion that there's no real danger. That's all it has to go off of. So we have to show our brain that there is no real danger with our accepting behaviors. Now, it does help to have a positive outlook. It does help to not entertain those negative thoughts. Yes, that is very helpful, because the more we entertain those negative thoughts, the more of a reaction we're going to feel in the body, because we are sensitized. So our main key of not following thoughts is very helpful for your recovery, but you have to use those accepting behaviors. You have to show the brain with your behaviors that there is no real danger, because that's all it has to go off of. And like I said, it is helpful to not follow your thoughts, because the less obsession you do, the less feelings you're going to have, and the easier it is to use accepting behaviors, of course. But either way, as long as you're showing your brain with your accepting behaviors, you are rewiring your brain. But, you know, our two main keys combined, our two main keys together, not following those thoughts, using accepting behaviors, that's where, you know, that's where the money's at, you know. That's where you're going to find the most success if you use the two main keys together. But yeah, the brain is watching, guys. It is watching. It wants to see if there's a real danger or not. You have to show it that there isn't with your behaviors. Remind yourself of that. Remind yourself, I know there's no real danger. My brain doesn't know that. I need to show it that now. I need to show it that now. And while you're doing this, like I said, combine the two main keys. Negative thoughts come, you don't have to follow them. You can see them for what they are. Negative thoughts that are just going to play off my tired nerves, I don't have to bother arguing with that, because it's honestly pointless, and you can move on with your day. So use our two main keys together. Show your brain that there's no real danger, because you know there isn't. The real you knows there isn't. It's time to show the brain that. All right, you guys, I love each and every one of you. We are growing like crazy, and I am so thankful and grateful for all of you. I truly am. I can't express just how grateful I am. Thank you for being here. Thank you for helping me live out my dreams of being a YouTuber, of helping people every single day, you know. All the things about YouTube I love, you know, being able to help people every single day, being a YouTuber, which is just something I've always been passionate about and something I've always wanted to do. So, you know, you guys are making all of this come true for me, and in return, I'm going to help you the best that I can. So it's, you know, it's a win-win situation for everybody. So if you're new here, consider subscribing. We would love to have you here. Very loving, caring community. You don't want to miss out, all right? This community is one of the best that I've seen on YouTube, and I'm not bragging. Okay, maybe I'm bragging on you guys a little bit, but, you know, it's true. I have a very loving, caring community, so thank you guys for everything that you do. If you'd like to send a donation, you can do so through PayPal, shorter1993@live.com. You don't have to, but, of course, I am very grateful for every donation I get, but that's completely up to you. Thank you for being here regardless. You are important, and you are needed. I love you, and until next time, as always, stay awesome.